Ladies and gentlemen, Sandy and Mandy! Sharman, you join the ranks of the sad bastards.
You're the sad bastards paying for it.
Sandy and Mandy. Couple of lesbians, so don't waste your breath.
Which is which?
Sandy's the one in the wig.
Sandy, is it?
Look, will you do us a favour? 30 quid if you drive us home. Look, come on, it's West Norwood, it'll take you 10 minutes.
I'm not a cabbie, you can flag one down outside for a fiver.
I don't want a taxi, I need an escort.
Oi! Where is she?
She's gone.
You lying cow, where is she?
Trace!
Oh, come on.
Dave!
Stood up, I'm staying here.
Appreciate this. Thanks a lot.
How you doing?
So who's the psycho?
Look, if you want to do this on a regular basis, we could make it worth your while. I mean, we're earning decent money, you know?
No. I don't want your money. If you want a driver, I can give you a couple of numbers, but it's not my field.
Get out!
Stay down. Stay where you are. Back up on Renton Street.
Oh, God, well, he knows. He knows where we live. He's gone to the bloody house.
Do you want to ring the cavalry?
No.
Have you got anywhere you can go?
Yeah, it's Tenerife full. Got any other bright ideas?
It's sexier putting them on than taking them off, isn't it? Never mind. You are a grown-up. All right, babe.
It is appreciated, you know. I mean, you will get paid for this.
Don't worry about it. We'll say it's on the house. So how do you two know about me anyway?
JJ, just said you were a bit handy. So what do you do?
I'm a private investigator.
Oh, yeah? What's that, nipping about with a camera? Lifting up people's toilet lids, that kind of thing. Hey, you done any murders?
Trace! Come on, we got the eagle later.
It's our last time for the bars. Hey, Des will be hanging around the eagle, won't he? You don't want your fingers broken again, do you?
I need to go to work.
Nick, I can't find that bloody... Ooh! That sounded far away. I think it was
the outside world. Oh, you look like shit.
Thanks.
Still not as bad as I feel. You have noticed I've got a cold. Oh, customs. This is Mr. George Bright.
Hi. How you doing?
I saw your name in the book.
You might as well take your germs home, Aggie. See you later.
It's about my daughter, Sophie. She left home suddenly and, I don't know where she is.
How old?
18.
Disappeared when?
3 days ago. Look, she's never done this before. The further it goes on, I'm just worried sick.
You went to the police, yeah?
Oh, yeah, I've been to the police. I mean, they're of the opinion she's in no danger, and I basically got to sit on my arse and wait. I love her far too much for that.
Was she seeing anyone?
Well, boyfriends. Not that I know of, no.
You had any breakfast?
No. Her mum passed away about 4 years ago, and, well, she ain't. I'm not a very good father. I'll admit that, I'm not stupid.
How do you mean?
But I'm not patient enough, I'm not sensitive enough, I'm not subtle enough. I mean, I've got a business to run. I'm not 100% in tune with what she's got going for her, you know?
Oh, yeah. Can I get a special one of tea?
Yeah, a cup of tea, 2 sugars, please, mate. Look, it's a picture of Sophie. Taken about a year ago.
What sort of business are you in?
Commercial printing, stationery, publicity material, you know.
Has Sophie got any friends I can talk to?
Well, she goes to clubs. She loves dancing, but she never brings any of them out.
Do you mind if I go to her room?
No, do what you have to do.
I'm only asking because kids Sophie's age can spring a few surprises. I'm just saying be warned.
Maybe you'll think of something the police didn't think of.
Coffee would be great if you're making one. Black one, sugar. Tell me she was a model.
No, it's just a fantasy of hers.
Fantasy? Howard Mayles isn't your high street photographer.
I know, I paid his bills. Look, if she wanted to go horse riding, I'd buy her a pony, you know? If she had an interest in drawing, I'd find her a tutor, you know, buy her paints, anything, other than a studio, you know? If there's anything I wouldn't have done for her.
George, you don't know any of her friends. You don't know what she did when she wasn't at home, apart from clubbing. I'm not being funny, but you don't seem to know much about her at all.
Like I was saying, I'm a lousy father. Look, I just want a chance to make it up to her. I love her.
What happened to that coffee?
I'm sorry.
So if you think of anything else, just give me a bell, yeah?
Yeah, thanks. Thanks very much.
Trevor.
What are you doing here?
I've just taken on a missing person.
Here's Gil. Morning. How's the wife?
We're divorced. She's married a dentist.
Oh, yeah. I did hear that. Margie and me are still together. Amazing, really.
Yeah, listen, it's a bit embarrassing.
No worries, Nick. I didn't appreciate her. You stepped in and made her happy. Taught me a lesson. Got to live your life, haven't you? So, professionals aren't good enough for you then, Mr. Bright.
I wouldn't say that, Sergeant.
No, well, if we had to go tearing round after all the teenagers who did a runner, we'd never get anything else done.
Perhaps.
No disrespect, but that's what I came to tell you. We've no information coming in from the usual sources. In my experience, that's usually good news. I wouldn't be over-concerned if I were you. Nick would back me up on that one, wouldn't you, Nick?
Well, it's like you say, I've got a bit more time on my hands than you.
So where do you think she's gone, then? The gypsies, the fairies, or a travelling circus?
I don't know yet.
So, your Laura's with a dentist, eh? Filling a cavity.
So, can I speak to Judith?
Well, she's out.
Oh, come on. She must be back from school by now.
Nick, it's half term.
I thought I was having her for half term.
Nick.
Are you saying that it's too late?
Everything's organized now. I can't
start. Okay, fine. But she's all right, yeah? And you're okay? Good. All right, I better go. I'll speak to you soon, yeah?
Yeah, okay.
Someone should tell her she's wasting her money. Went down a bomb in there. How's it hanging with you?
How do you mean?
What?
Please.
Well, rule number one, you should always look like you're enjoying yourself. I mean, they're nice shots, but she's all over the place. Can't say yes with your mouth and no with your eyes. Well, it's not something you learn. Ask Dawn. Isn't she lovely?
Right. I won't be long.
We're coming with you.
No. You'd be too much like competition.
Chicken gear.
Swish.
Hello, gorgeous. Do you want to get changed a couple of seconds, please?
Howard.
Yeah.
You're a what? Lucy, could you show this gentleman to the door, please? I could call the police, you know.
What, with the amount of Charlie I can see there, don't be silly.
Yeah, good point. What can I do for you?
Do you recognise these contacts? Sophie Bryan.
Yeah. So, what's the problem?
She's gone missing.
5 minutes, please, people.
You don't usually do audition shots, do you?
No, but everyone's got to have a portfolio when they get started.
So Sophie's a friend? I mean, you wouldn't do this for anyone.
No, I met her in a club and she talked me into doing it.
It's pretty persuasive for an 18-year-old. 17, then?
Yeah, well, she was. Persuasive.
So what do you get in return?
Not a very good detective, are you, Mr. Sharman?
Was she making it as a model?
Nah. Nice girl. Rich daddy and all that, but pretty kids like that. They need a lot more than she had to get to the top. Take Matilda over there. She looked like a horse when she was younger.
Where was this club you met?
Pie.
You been there recently?
No. She also used to hang out in Route 39, Gonzo, Lankers, Tommy Trance. Well, you know, it could be any one of 20 clubs.
If you bump into her, give me a ring. Was that a yes?
Yes.
When I met Dawn, she was all lace knickers in the David Rose Orchestra, and I'm not joking. Well, that was Des's taste, of course. Well, he's an animal. So what do you expect?
How did she get involved in the first place?
Same way as I did. Yeah, Des managed the act when her husband died.
Bit young for a widow, isn't she?
Colin, yeah, nice fella. Good manager as well. Car crash, went out like a light. She didn't know what to do. That's when that pig face moved in. started telling her what to wear, how to dance. Before long, he was calling it his house and he was ripping her off.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Tracy, shut up.
All right, I know, I talk too much, yeah?
You're like a bloody Australian.
Look, we're in his flat. He just wanted some background, that's all.
Oh, yeah, did he ask? Did you? No, I thought not. Well, if all we're doing is CVs, then how come mine always has to come first? I mean, if your mouth's twitching, Tracy, just talk about your bloody self.
I forgot. Look, Dawn. I'm sorry, Dawn.
Right. I'll be here when you finish, OK?
All right. Look, sorry about the blowout earlier. It's a bit out of order, you know.
You missed a really good fight.
Come on, girl, shift it!
I'm not the police, which might be lucky for you. You'll have to wait and see. Do you know a girl called Sophie Bright?
No.
She comes in here.
No, I told you, I don't know. I don't know her.
Mess me about.
A lot of my friends didn't exactly like Sophie.
What made you so special?
Well, she was weird and that, but she used to give it away. Smack. Coke. She always had it. I never saw her take it. She never wanted money for it. She's just weird.
Why did she need to do that?
I told you, she was weird, didn't I?
Where was she getting the gear?
I don't know. I only do smack now and again.
Go on, piss off. I thought strippers travelled light, you know, a couple of G strings and a Sainsbury's bag.
Well, strippers probably do.
Oh, character dancers don't.
Well, it's an adventure. You know, when we stop having a laugh, we'll call it a day.
The money doesn't come into it, no?
Well, I'm not ready for doing the tills in a petrol station. Well, not yet, anyway.
Never.
Listen, you can both stay at my place until this all calms down, but I'm going to be in and out, so I won't be setting no table for you.
Oh, yeah? What made you change your mind? One of your jobs fall through?
Well, it's like JJ said, I'm helpful. Terry, man. Terry? Southall? T.S.? Hello?
Down there on the right. Doodlebugs? It's an epidemic, old son. Yeah. Easy and cheap. Yeah, well, the media's hardly our closest ally. Well, one minute you're up in arms about heroin abuse on some council estate, the next you're coyly suggesting that anyone who's cool is snarfing up half of Bolivia before breakfast. Really? Yeah. Go on. Well, if you need any more, call me.
Sharman, you villain!
How you doing? I think your intercom's lost its batteries.
Ah, that's precious. She's searching for the one eternal love. And you're not it.
You're looking a bit wired there, Tellboy.
Yeah, I am. Think I'm an hypocrite, don't you? I scoop up the addicts who can't take the bullshit.
So?
So? I've kicked the crap so many times, I'm an expert. I don't preach. How you doing, Nick?
I'm looking for a missing girl. She's had access to a lot of drugs. Gives them away, apparently. Somebody like that must get talked about in your circles. Name's Sophie Bryant.
Never heard of her. Beautiful girl.
Somebody might have.
Listen, I don't mind asking around as long as it's not too policey. I've got a reputation to think about, you know?
Terry, she's just a missing person. People are worried about her, me included.
I'll ask.
Nice one. So how's it all going?
Good.
Cheers.
Place is all mine, mate. What's the matter? Price of scrap gone through the ceiling.
I sold it. Nice chap.
Plenty of room for his guide dog.
Well, what do you think of it?
I think it'll make a really nice wheelbarrow. Why do you ask?
I thought you'd like her. Nah, she's a bit rough under 40, but you can always turn the radio on. Tony Blackburn seems to do it.
Oh, please tell me you're joking.
Take it or leave it. But if you take her, look after her, huh? She's not a bloody ram raider.
What is this?
Charlie's insisted on an upgrade. It's one of the perks of being a value customer.
Bren, you finished her brake pipes yet?
Yeah. Oh, let me. All right? Excuse me. That's her.
She's got four-wheel drive, leather upholstery, wood trim, well, woodish, and she's completely air-conditioned. In fact, she's got everything.
Can we go now? We're late.
Oh, your carriage awaits, madame.
Ah, ta.
6 miles to London and still no sign of Dick.
Yeah, can I get a large Jack Daniels, please?
You. I did everything for you, slags. You were better off when you listened to me, you old slapper. Oi! Dawn!
Are you Nick Sharman?
Oi! Dawn!
Sorry.
You come down here and you get your kit off for a load of...
As you can see.
You're dead, son.
Just a phone call from the bar.
Yeah, Nick Sharman.
If you're looking for Sophie Bright, you'll find her at 79 Madeira Road, Brixton. 79 Madeira, got it.
I mean, who the hell does he think he is? But what gives him the right to just come in here and... He doesn't own us.
Yeah, just calm down.
I can't... Look, have a drink. I tell you, he's lost it. He's off his head.
It's nothing a bit of daycare won't sort out. Listen, he's not going to get back in here again tonight. I've got to shoot off to Brixton, do a bit of business. I'll be back before your last set.
All right, you better. Give us another one of those.
Sharman. What were you doing in that house with an ounce of lethal grade heroin and a dead girl?
Oh, it's just a bit of concussion where someone put the boot in.
I was set up.
Really? What a surprise. What were you doing there?
I was looking for a missing girl called Sophie Bright. Her old man was paying me.
Yeah, he identified her.
It was her, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Your old mate Trevor Dix is tying all that up.
Shit. Look, I walked in the door. She was dead. I swear, Robert, if you try pulling me for this one...
Shut up and calm down. You were seen parking up at 10. They reckon the time of death was a couple of hours earlier. Now, I'm going to ask you again, what were you doing there?
I got a call at the Beresford in the West End. Bar staff took the call, so you can ask them. They told me that I'd find her there. I assumed alive.
Don't do that when I'm trying to interrogate you.
But don't try and interrogate me when I'm trying to make a call. Yeah, it's Nick Sharman. Is George Bright there, please? Can you tell him that I'm really, really sorry, but I would like to speak to him, yeah? Thanks. Oh, I don't feel very well.
You don't look it.
I tried ringing. You all right?
Am I all right? What's he done?
What?
Des.
No. No. These were of a slightly higher order than old Desi. Just.
I came earlier, but the police wouldn't let me in and wouldn't tell me anything.
I've found Sophie Bryant. Dead.
Oh, sorry.
Where's Trace?
Oh, she's getting some flowers.
I've been on to Charlie. He's going to throw you about.
I know. Don't worry.
And the keys to my flat, just keep them till, you know.
I would like to talk to you.
Just a quick visit. Yeah. Don't want to know what happened, okay?
What happened?
Hi. Hiya.
Hi.
What happened?
What happened? A man asked me to find his daughter.
Did you?
Yeah.
You mean she was dead? How? Did someone kill her?
What are you listening to?
Oasis. How did she die?
What, you're a big fan, are you?
I nearly went to see them in Edinburgh, but I just ended up with a T-shirt.
You should have your own room, Nick. Don't think he was in a fit state to book in, to be honest.
I know. They're a bit loud. Not quite you, but, well.
Oh, hello. Do you belong to him, then?
They're divorced.
So, you from round here?
Aberdeen, actually.
Oh, we did a show there, didn't we?
What, are you singers?
Yeah. Dancers. Well, dancers, singers. We do children's parties, don't we?
We'll be off then.
I'll see you later, yeah?
Oh, and me.
Trace, come on. Come on.
Oh, you are strong.
Thanks, Charlie. See ya.
Do 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 do.
think you look great.
Oh, lighten up, Trace.
Yeah, lovely. Listen, can we get through this sharpish tonight? I've got a train to catch.
What train?
I told you, it's my mum's anniversary.
You didn't. You saw us, didn't you? Trace, did you see us
kissing? Yeah, I caught the tail end.
Well, do you mind?
Mind what? He's done us a few favours. Come on. We've got to get paid.
But Trace.
Mr. Sharman!
I could just hear his bike outside. I don't think he knows which flat it is.
I need some ice.
Ice.
Where's Tracy?
What? She's gone to her mum's in Shoreham.
Why's she on the Shoreham?
She's gone to see her mum.
How long for?
I don't know. She didn't say.
What are you doing? What's this?
You said you wanted ice.
Yeah, for my nose.
Drink that and save the ice.
Don't! I'm not exactly fit for a rumble, you know what I mean? Aye, aye, he's on the move. Charlie? Oh, hiya, where the bloody hell's Charlie? Look, go out of the window, get on the roof so we can see you. Go on. No, it's all right, we got a bit of trouble here. Yeah. Yeah. Go on.
Even a bright lad like you ought to figure out they don't exactly go together, do they?
What are you going to do with the money anyway? Facelift? I mean, look at you and look at her and tell me something. I mean, you're not exactly the dog's bollocks, are you, you ugly little runt?
You see, she's mates with him. He's mates with my boss. My boss knows everybody. That's a lot of people and we all talk. And if it gets out that you got duffed up by a woman, you'll have no friends at all, will you? Will you?
I didn't stop Tracy because she was saying anything wrong. No, everything she said was true. After Colin died, I didn't know what I was doing. Dares and all his mates, they were just part of the crowd.
I'm not asking, you know.
No, I know you're not. Shut up. No, he was great because he organised the funeral and everything. You know, I couldn't have done that. I can't even remember him moving in. I just remember him being there, you know, and taking charge. And you know when you do something stupid and then it all clears? You know, and you're putting it all together and you're feeling completely stupid.
Tell me about it.
Yeah. Well, I was on stage down at the Albion dancing. Delayed shock or something, I don't know, but... Well, I'm looking at Des and he's yelling at me. He's yelling, move! Keep moving! And there's all these kids, you know, these boys, they're all getting off on it. And I'm standing there and I'm thinking, my husband's only been dead 7 months. I'm standing... crying on stage and he's screaming at me.
Yeah, but come on, I mean, there's lots of pricks like Des about. That's not your fault.
He wasn't why I was crying. I was crying because the bloke I just put in the ground, the bloke I'd been mourning for 7 months, Colin wasn't that different. He still wanted his 20%. I was crying because I'm looking at Des and I'm realising they're both peas out of the same bloody pond and the only difference is that one's dead and the other's not. Tracy is the most important thing that ever happened to me. I worked with her 7 nights in a row sometimes. Des, he was so thick. Oh, it took him weeks to realise we got it together. And then we were getting gigs on our own and, you know, we were moving in together. And he went ape. Look, I'm not saying all this because I want protection. You know, I don't need looking after.
I'm not offering. I've told you, I'm nobody's minder. So Tracy achieved all this.
What? What's that supposed to mean?
You've got to give yourself some credit for getting this far. You know, you can't keep owing Tracy all the time. And if she's a mate, she shouldn't expect it.
You haven't understood a single word, have you?
What do you mean?
Sorry.
What's the matter?
No, I'll get a taxi. I'm wasting my time here.
Dawn!
Appreciate you coming, but I've got to bury her now.
It's lousy timing, I know. I've just come to say I'm sorry.
What a coroner talked about was drugs. I mean, I felt as if I was a million miles away, you know? I had no idea what was going on.
Like I said, I'm sorry.
Yeah, well, I'll pay you up to date and then for next week.
No, don't worry about that
now.
No,
it's all right, it's all right. I've already made the check out. Cheers.
Thanks. Does he know any of the details?
Well, we didn't tell him your fan lying next to her, if that's your question. Probably did the right thing.
So all that's cleared up, is it?
Well, that's none of your business now, really, is it, Nick?
If that's the lottery numbers, I've given it up on the advice of my bookie. Stand more chance of winning a smile from the tax man than you do the rollover.
I didn't mean to sneak about.
No?
Keys.
See you around. No number.
I didn't ask. This lot was downstairs. See
you. Dawn. Look, I know you've had a rough time, but I don't like being messed about either.
Get your coat. I'm taking you out.
I need a shower.
No, you don't need a shower for where we're going. Well, come on. Do you really enjoy what you do?
I never wake up looking forward to it.
Would you change it if you could?
No.
I've been asked to go to Acapulco. Tracy's worked out with a guy she used to work for down at Clooney's. His brother runs a bar there.
Are you tempted?
I don't know. I get a bit nervous about changes that big.
I know.
No, you don't. You're just saying that.
Yeah, I'm saying that because that's who I am.
Really, I am.
Dawn, where did this tape come from?
The parcel. It was downstairs in the post.
Hi, Nick Sharman. My name's Sophie, Sophie Bright.
I thought she was dead.
I hear that people are worried about me.
Is.
And I wanted to put the record straight and let you know once and for all that I am all right. We haven't met, and I don't think we're going to. I hope you take my advice and stop looking for me. You see, friends of mine have been embarrassed by friends of yours asking questions. Just let me get on with my life. The problem is, you've got the wrong idea about just about everything. And maybe once you realise you've been conned, you'll leave me alone. I'm all right. Really, I am.
But you weren't. Yeah.
Oi, Sharman.
Terry.
I'm no target and I'm no bunny. You lied, you bastard.
What are you talking about?
Straightforward, you said, just missing. Well, I'm telling you now, you do not prat around with these guys. You stuck me in the firing line, Sharman.
Terry, hang on a minute. Calm down. What guys?
Your Sophie Bright. She's in with some heavy people, Nick.
Sophie Bright's dead.
Yeah, well, I'm sorry about that. But I'm no gangster. Don't ask me no more favours, all right?
Terry! Shit. Listen, I don't know what the bloody hell's going on anymore. But, I'm gonna have to shoot off and see somebody. I don't usually bail out like this. Have we done something bad?
No, it's okay.
Good. I won't be long.
It was you called, was it? Tell me, have you ever thought of being an undertaker? You know, the way you attract all these dead bodies? You can make a fortune.
He's a friend, all right?
Then the least you owe me is an accurate statement. Nasty, is it?
He rang me earlier on tonight. He kept going on and on about Sophie Bright. He sounded really wired.
Stoned. Or was the office face again or not? In your reliable civilian opinion, Mr. Sharman.
Look, I wouldn't know and neither would you. Tell him to behave.
Soon tell. He's got fresh track marks on his arm. It was his own gun. Argentine army pistol. Dum-dum bullet. So what's that at face value? Suicide, sir?
See what happened.
Have you spoken to the police?
Silly question. Look, did Terry top himself?
Because I don't believe he did.
I'm a good mate of his, and I'd hate him to go down on record as a suicide because he'd be letting a lot of people down. But if you don't start opening your mouth, that's exactly what the coroner's going to tag him with.
Not once friend of a friend sort of thing. It starts quiet, then the loudest one starts getting angry and just sort of...
Hang on a minute, you were there?
In the flat under. Sophie, I heard. T.S. is stamping up and down, shouting your name, saying he don't know what they're talking about. What did they tell you? They kept saying.
Me?
They go, Sturrock, Sturrock, Sturrock.
What's Sturrock?
He's a barrister, addict. T.S. sorted him years back. He came to see T.S. yesterday.
Go on.
He tells him to go or he's going to fry him through the wall. They just shot him.
Where are you going? You're not going back there.
Yeah.
Thanks. It's okay, it's for Piers Sturrock from his chamber. Got some briefs.
Leave them with me.
Actually, no. To tell you the truth, I'm a bit sick of only getting this far. It's about time the tight sob bought me a few drinks for my troubles.
All right, go on. Who's down there?
I've gone blind.
There, in the corner.
Oh, of course. Thanks. Piers Sturrock.
Who's this?
My name's Nick Sharman. I'm a private investigator.
You'll be wanting the curry house on the corner. Look, can we find out how this joker got in here?
You spoke to Terry Southall yesterday afternoon. I got a feeling you want that conversation to stay private.
I'm sorry,
He was found dead last night.
Outside. Scotch.
You told Terry something about Sophie Bright and then Terry got killed.
I haven't a clue what you're talking about. I bumped into Terry for the first time in years. He's an old client.
What are you talking about? You're an old smackhead. You were his client. Now cut the crap.
I was here last night. I really can prove it.
So after you spoke to Terry, who else did you speak to?
No one.
If you lighten me now, Sturrock, you've got nowhere to go. What is it about Sophie Bright? She gets to people even from the grave.
What? What?
You're not exactly up to speed, are you? Are you sure you're clean?
Yes, that's all bloody history.
Well, it's obviously occurred to you that whoever killed Terry might go for you. So what's puzzling me is why an influential bloke like yourself isn't on the blower screaming for police protection. I mean, if all we're talking about is the drugs, you'd have done that already. Bigger blokes than you have knocked that kind of history on the head. So why are you being blackmailed? You are being blackmailed, aren't you?
It was all bloody ages ago. I don't know why they should go for me. It's so unfair. There were others, much worse, much more prominent.
Much worse than what?
I was sent this.
Is that Sophie?
Yeah.
How old is she there? 11, 12?
13. I swear to you now, that picture is all there is. I never... They had these parties in a warehouse.
With children?
Young girls. I never really understood those people, but that's where the drugs were, and that's all I ever went for, I swear.
So who invited you?
George Bright.
What, he pimped his own child at people like you?
Don't say that. I wasn't one of them.
No? So it's George Bright that's blackmailing you?
Well, who else could it be?
And this is what you told Terry? You showed Terry this?
Yeah. I've got money, Sham.
What are they asking for?
$20,000. Look, I don't care about the money. I can find the money, but... my head's disappearing, and I don't know where this is leading.
You want sympathy from me?
Just put a stop to this, won't you? Before it gets out of hand. Please.
Get out of my face.
There's a woman out here wants you.
What's she look like?
Old, ugly. Chest like a wheelchair ramp.
No, I'm busy.
He's in here, love. Hi, Nick.
It's all right, Aggie.
Thought it might be. Excuse me.
You vanished on me.
Oh, you didn't ring.
No, the case got a bit out of hand. Flat wasn't too safe. How you doing?
Oh, I'm great. I'm getting a flight tonight. And I just wondered if you wanted to drop me at the airport.
Acapulco?
Yeah.
Just like that?
Well, it's good money.
What, and this is instead of a real conversation? You and Tracy?
No, Sandy and Mandy.
Look, you know, I'm not saying that one night makes a marriage, but you certainly didn't make it seem like it was one night. What about me?
What about me? Oh, now you sound like Des.
Oh, that would suit you down to the ground, wouldn't it? Me jumping through all the right hoops so you can turn around and say, oh, bloody hell, I recognise that one. I mean, if that's what you're into and that makes you happy, that's fine, but I don't play games.
Right, well, you think what you like. Look, I didn't come here for a row, Nick. Right, I'll get a taxi.
I'll take you. What time's the flight?
Check-in's at 5, but, you know, just don't bother yourself.
I'll pick you up at 3:30.
All right? Don't look at me like that.
What?
It was never a competition, you know. I go along with what she wants.
Who's this?
It's Sophie Bright, Mr. Sharman.
Sophie?
I want to talk to you. Will you meet me?
No. Sorry, look, I don't know what's going on, but there's no way I'm falling for that one twice.
Please, Nick. I need your help.
No, I...
Meet me in Norwood Cemetery in half
Sophie?
An hour.
Nick, what are we doing here?
I've just got to do something. I won't be long.
Are you sure you want to take me to the airport?
Yeah, of course. Don't worry. What? Make it easy. Why does George want people to believe you're dead?
Maybe because he wants me dead. Or someone's pushing him. I wish I knew.
You said he wasn't your father.
He's my foster father. It took me all my strength to get away from him.
I'm sorry. I know what he was into.
Well, the bit I'm really sorry about was when he fell in love with me. That's when it got really sick.
Is George Bright blackmailing Piers Sturrock?
You know Sturrock?
Some kind of revenge.
George Bright isn't capable of blackmail. Any tosser can shift hard porn and drugs to the markets there that's mouth wide open.
He's into drugs as well.
Not that you call him a drug dealer, not in street terms. You see, the people that want his parties usually need something else to blame all their other disgusting habits on. So he dishes out Class A like they're smarties. They all trust him, his clients. What he hasn't figured out is that once their trust goes, George Bright is a pile of cow shit.
What about Howard Mayles?
George wanted someone to do the dirty pictures for his magazine. Howard was a young bloke then, ambitious. George bribed him and set him up with the gear and the premises.
Yeah, but Mayles is a top photographer.
He is now. You see, the joke was on George because Howard actually had some talent. And the only one with any shame. He was a good mate to me.
Who was the dead girl?
You're meant to be the detective. I don't know. Somebody they'd finish with, someone like me. George probably fell in love with her and all. I saw her being buried, you know. I saw George crying over the coffin. I had to throw up twice. I want George Bright killed. That's the only reason why I'm here.
Don't be daft, Sophie.
I'm serious. I'll pay you. If I don't get him, Nick, he'll get me. I know he will.
Why don't you just go to the police? Tell them everything.
Because I can do better than go to the police. As I got older, the clients got richer and more famous. I can have them all now.
What, you're the blackmailer?
George thought I was too stupid to think for myself. You know, it's dangerous when you do that. I have put the fear of God into so many bastards. They're all paying a fortune.
It's not going to work out for you, Sophie.
It's worked right up to now. You know that GP found hanging in his own surgery? Great loss to the community, pressure of work. Bollocks. I did that without even lifting a finger. The one I'll never persuade to blow his brains out is George Bright. And I want you to do that.
You're barking up the wrong tree. I'm not a hitman.
Wouldn't the world be a better place without him?
Yeah, and wouldn't it be a worse place without people like you? And me, for that matter. Think about it, Sophie. If this came on top, we'd both be looking at 15 years. You'd be 30-odd, I'd be 50. Do you think we'd be satisfied?
£20,000, Sharman. I got this by courier today.
Piers Sturrock?
That's how scared they are. It's yours.
Sophie, listen to me. You're not even 19 yet. Quit while you're ahead. Get on with your life. This sort of money could take you a long way from here. College, anything.
I'm begging you, Sharman. I just want him dead.
Get down! Sophie. Wasn't Sophie Bright.
What are you talking about? She was identified by her father.
Sophie Bright's just been shot dead in Norwood Cemetery. Whoever shot her nearly killed me as well.
What is all this about?
What this is about is a child prostitution racket run by George Bright. He's got a warehouse on the Bailey Road, but that's not all he's into, is it?
Isn't it?
Come on, Robbo, you're a lot smarter than that. If he's trading on your manor, then you know exactly what the score is.
You're certainly very close to the wind here, Sharman. Where'd you get all this?
I've been doing a job of work. The information's yours now. I just find it a bit weird that he can carry on like that unmolested.
What exactly are you saying?
What I'm saying is, it sounds a bit dodgy to me.
Would you like to make a statement to that effect?
There's a lot of stuff on your patch not getting cleared up. Now I'm telling you about it. So if nothing gets done, I'll know why it's not getting done and who's not doing it. Yeah, George, it's Nick Sharman.
Oh, come on, mate.
George.
Hello, Nick. Busy?
Yeah, all right.
Do you want a coffee?
Yeah, that'd be nice.
Black one, sugar one.
You remember? Listen, I've just turned up to say I'm sorry about turning up to the funeral the other day. You know, it's a bit embarrassing, all that money and everything.
That's fine.
How'd it go? It must have been awful.
No, it was a very nice service, you know. Some friends there, you know. People have been ringing a week offering support.
I've seen her.
Seen her?
Who do you think? You put someone else's kid in the ground, you piece of shit.
Look, Nick, I've made a terrible mistake. She phoned, you know, she was in trouble. People are trying to kill her. She just wanted
God,
some...
this is some performance. There you go. It's 20 grand. That's what she offered me. 20 grand to kill you because of what you've done to her, you and your friends.
Well, you like a bit of it.
Where'd you hear that? Wouldn't be an old police colleague of mine, would it?
It's 50 grand.
What do you take me for? You're some sick... Nah, not impressed. You're used to other people doing that for you.
You're not impressed? Well, you want me to impress you?
Get up! Get up! Come here! Where is she? Get up! Get up, you slag! Get up! Where is she? Where is she? Where is she? You slag! I blow your brains all over the table! Where is she?
She's dead, George!
She can't be. It's him.
She's dead.
Where is she?
Not here.
She's dead.
What's he trying to get?
Wait! I told you to wait!
What's the matter with
him? Where is he?
Not here.
You lied to me.
You're trying to get us nicked or what?
Shut up!
I'm warning you. Put the gun down.
Shut up.
Put the gun down, George. Put the gun down. I'm warning you.
Drop your weapon. I repeat.
Put the gun down, George.
Put
the gun down. I'm warning you. Don't shoot at me, you prat.
Can't get enough, can you, Sharman?
Oi! Did you know I was in there when you let loose that lot?
I didn't know he was going to start shooting at us.
So what's going to happen to Dix?
Trevor's a hero now. Ambushed in the execution of his duty as an undercover policeman.
Oh, come on, you can't be serious.
Who cares? I mean, if he survives, he's not going to be a copper anymore, is he? It's not my problem. You see, Nicholas, I may not be a member of Mensa, but I know how to watch my arse. The problem with Trev was, it's just too blatant.
Sharman, you join the ranks of the even sadder bastards.
It's
only because you're paying your turns, Les. I mean, you know, I got nothing against false tits, but false tits that can't sing, please.
What happened?
Didn't like the look of the plane. Definite case of metal fatigue. Large brandy, no ice. Oh, do you want another?
Yeah, why not? It's not every day an ex-client offers to buy me a drink. Where's Tracy?
Halfway across the Atlantic by now. Trying to make up her mind whether to call herself Sandy or Mandy. Anyway, I'm back now. And you're the first person I wanted to see. Well, work it out, Sharman. And all the love that you've been saving up, you'll be spending like a clown. And when you have, let me know.